Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Dorian Gonsalves, who is the CEO of the Belvoir Group. And a very warm welcome to you, Dorian.
Hi there, Thomas.
Great to see you again. And we're going to be chatting a bit today about your final results from calendar year 22. So perhaps you'd like to start by giving us what you think are the highlights.
Yeah, sure. I mean, first and foremost, it's our 26th year of unbroken profit growth, which I'm very pleased to say that. So revenue up 14%. Most parts of the business had growth last year, apart from estate agency, which has sort of normalized back to sort of pre-COVID levels. But, you know, that was forecast and that's understandable. Dividend has increased by 6% and is forecast to continue to grow over the next 3 years. So, all in all, it was, another strong year for us.
And that increase in revenues, Dorian, it was another double-digit increase. So that's obviously very pleasing for you. But you really did just sneak over the line with that 26th year of increasing profits, didn't you?
We did. I think, like all businesses, we have we've seen our costs increase like for like by around 6%. We've made acquisitions again last year, which we're very pleased with the businesses that we bought. And we bought one financial services business, and then we've also invested in a small sort of personal agent business that is it's small at the moment, but we do intend to build that business over time. So we also finished the year net cash for the first time since 2015, and that was after paying out around 4 million. Of consideration for those two acquired businesses. So, you know, good finish.
And it was after dealing with the mini budget in September, wasn't it, which sent shockwaves through the whole industry?
It did. I mean, that was a particularly difficult period, you know, the last quarter of last year. The mini budget did do, it sent a shockwave through the mortgage market and, in my opinion, led to an element of paralysis, really, where, you know, if you were thinking of remortgaging in the last quarter of last year, chances are you held off. You know, some of the horror stories of rates might be 8%, 9%, you know, were sort of circulating. But in reality, that hasn't happened. I'm a perfect example of that personally. I've got a mortgage deal at the moment that's due to come to an end. I'm on 2%. I had a quote a week or so ago from my lender at 3.99%. So, yes, it's an increase, but no, it's not the level that we're expecting or commentators were expecting towards the end of last year.
And you're expecting that relative normalization to start feeding back into some more positive performance for the company probably in the second half of this year.
Yeah, exactly right. So what we're seeing now is much more activity on the mortgage side. So lettings is already so far this year 5% up, which is to be expected. You know, rents are increasing, demand for rental properties is very strong. We're 2% down on estate agency so far this year as the market returns back to what I call our normal levels, which again is forecast. And on the financial services side of the business, written mortgage business is down as it was in Q4 last year. But we are starting to see lots more activity in the market. And as you rightly say, we're expecting a recovery on financial services in H2.
And let's have a little look at that increase in demand for rental properties, because that's been something that's been quite striking recently. So what's driving that increase in demand?
The Rightmove report are reporting that rental demand is 50% higher now than it was before the pandemic, which is extremely high. So there are fewer properties on the market and more people looking for properties. So demand is vastly outstripping supply. The real answer to that is that we need more rental properties in the UK. Over the last 18 months, the sector has increased in size. So we've seen lots of new purchases happen across property in the last 2 years. Some of these properties that have changed hands have come into the hands of landlords. So the sector has increased by around 170,000 units, but it's simply not enough, Thomas. You know, we need more properties, and it's a simple matter of supply and demand, which is driving rental inflation.
And just finally, Dorian, are there any other trends that you've observed from your position there in the cockpit of the sector?
I think it's fascinating. I mean, you know, it was very difficult to forecast what was going to happen with property sales and property prices this year. I suspect the property prices will cool off. And most commentators are saying that property prices will fall somewhere between 5 and 10% this year. That hasn't happened yet, may I add. Rightmover saying that rental inflation has cooled to 3% year on year. But it'll be interesting to see what happens in the second half of the year. But people are still buying properties. 230,000 properties in the UK have been sold subject to contract so far this year. So people are still moving.
Understood. Always a pleasure to get your insights, Dorian. And thank you very much for your time today. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Sauce.